The next three works on the program, the first by Mary Ellen Childs and then two by Meredith Monk, are all in the minimalist style. So what you have with this style are somewhat simple and straightforward and easily recognizable patterns that interweave to create something that's larger than the sum of its parts. Thank you. The final piece on the first half is by the great Joan Tower. I've heard that she has recently, or has in the recent past, had a piece performed with the Nashville Symphony, the Fanfare for the Uncommon Woman. So you may be familiar with her work. We are absolutely in love with everything that she writes, and we hope that you feel the same.
Thank you.
The common thread in the second half of the program is that all the pieces have some influence of popular styles. So the first set is by the California-born composer Gabriela Manafranc, but her heritage is Peruvian. So the first movement is charangos, which is a type of Andean string instrument. And then there's the children singing, and then the village dance.
Thank you.
The next piece on the program is by African-American composer Dolores White, and is inspired by a trip that she took to Cuba. So you'll hear traditional Cuban rhythms and also the use of the claves. Thank you. piece, I'd just like to thank Dr. Clark for having us here. We go way back, as he mentioned. If there are some Canimators out there, I just want you to all know that you're very fortunate to have Dr. Clark and Dr. Koh here. They're marvelous teachers, incredible pianists, and you should all be very proud to study with them. So the last piece that we have here is Tenement Rhapsody by Amanda Harber. The influences you'll hear in this piece are some jazz and rock influences. So thank you all for being here tonight. I know that the pandemic is keeping audiences away, but I'm glad you all braved, stayed safe, and hopefully enjoyed our concert. Thank you. Thank you.
you.